Okay, part 1.
Okay, hello, hi, assalamualaikum. So, hari ni kita nak sambung belajar chapter 2, Cell as the Basic Unit of Life. Okay, walaupun kita cuti, tetap juga kita kena on kita punya lesson macam biasalah. So, chapter 2, Cell as the Basic Unit of Life. So, kalau awak tengok kat sini ni buku teks kita . Ada gambar pokok. Okay, dalam chapter ni awak akan study cell. Okay, cell structure, function and organization. And part 2, cell respiration and photosynthesis. Okay, saya rasa awak pernah dengar apa itu respiration and also photosynthesis. So, kita akan belajar yang lebih mendalam dalam bab ni. Okay, so these are the some of the keywords. So, the first one, you must know cell, unicellular organism, multicellular organism, microscope, nucleus, cytoplasm, chloroplast, okay, palisade cell, epidermis cell, tissue, organ, system, organism, cell respiration, and also photosynthesis. So, dalam banyak-banyak ni, yang mana yang awak tak pernah dengar? So, semua kita akan belajar di dalam bab ni. Okay, the first part is the cell structure. Cell. Okay, it's about cell. Mana-mana pun awak belajar, mesti start dengan cell kalau awak belajar sains lah. So, kalau sekarang form 1 awak belajar cell, nanti tingkatan 4 biologi awak belajar cell lagi. Nanti awak masuk universiti pun awak belajar tentang cell lagi. Cell ni memang unik. So, everything is structured dia lain. Every cell structure lain-lain, function lain-lain and also have different organization. So, kita terus tengok. What is cell? So, macam tu kita jom pergi tengok dekat kita punya slideshow lah. So, this is our slideshow. Okay. What is cell? The first thing you need to know, cell is the basic unit of life. Cell is the basic unit of life or living thing lah. Okay, size ni dia punya, macam mana tu cell? Pernah nampak ke? Awak pernah nampak? Tak pernah nampak because the size is very microscopic. It means you only can be seen under a microscope. Under a microscope. So, kalau awak boleh bayang. Awak boleh bayang rumah. Okay, rumah. Okay, macam mana nak hasilkan sebuah rumah? Okay, mesti awak gunakan susun batu-bata. So, sama macam konsep kita, how organism is alive now. Macam mana organism form. Manusia terbentuk, macam mana boleh jadinya kucing, macam mana jadinya pokok. Okay, semua berasal daripada cell. Just like how bricks made houses. Okay, macam tu . So, the basic unit called cell. So, all our body is also made up of cell. Okay, so these are the person that first encounter cell under a microscope. Okay. So, it also says that cell resembles a microscopic factory. Kilang, ada macam-macam proses yang berlaku kat dalam kilang. Awak tengok kat sini je lah. Okay, so sama macam cell. So there are a lot of processes that happen inside our cell, which we call as life processes ataupun life function. Okay, such as grow. Oh silap, bukan life processes tu. Okay, cells carry out, bukan dalam cell. So, cell ni membantu life processes such as growth, respiration, reproduction and also excretion. Okay, so macam mana daripada satu cell can become a lot, can become more cell, a lot of cell. So, because cell undergo division processes. Okay, division processes ni untuk form new cell and also replace damaged cell. Okay, form new cell and to replace damaged cell. So, from one cell, satu, divide into two, so you dah dapat dua cell. So, these two cell divided again. So, dua dah jadi empat. So, from four cell, divide into two. So, it will get a lot. So, from one cell, it will become a lot of cell and eventually it will form a tissue and organ. Also, organism which we will later look into. Okay, so these are normal cell. Macam mana dia nak tahu dia kena divide ke apa ke? Tak apa, itu nanti kita belajar nanti. Okay, so what happen if cell undergo Abnormal division. Okay, here. So, bila dia abnormal, division dia membahagi secara tak terkawal. Uncontrolled cell division can cause cancer cell. Okay, ni contoh cancer cell lah. Normal biasa je, tapi disebabkan ada something that is triggering the division, it becomes uncontrolled. This uncontrolled will become, orang kata, lumps ataupun ketubuhan. And eventually will become cancer cell because of the uncontrolled division. So, causes of cancer is unknown. Masih tak tahu apa punca asalnya, tapi ada macam-macam things that can trigger cancer. Okay, pernah dengar kan rokok akan menyebabkan cancer kan? So, because in the cigarettes, they have this one. Tobacco. And then from the diet here bukan diet yang tak makan tu. Diet here means pemakanan. So because of the sometimes pemakanan juga trigger cancer. Okay, percentage terbesar dia adalah from tobacco ataupun daripada dalam rokok, and also from your diet. Okay, symptom dia ada macam-macam symptom, tapi antaranya ada change in bowel or bladder habits. Okay, mungkin awak ada penyakit yang macam tak boleh baik. Macam sakit dekat bahagian kaki, lutut kan. Lutut sakit je, tak tahu sebab apa sakit. Better pergi check lah. So, maybe juga ada orang unusual bleeding or discharge. Asyik bleeding je, tak tahu. Kat hidung tu asyik bleeding je. Okay, so go for a check. Jangan simpan lama-lama. Ada thickening, maybe ada lump in the breast. Ada macam lump ni apa kita panggil, tumbuhan lah pada bahagian dada. Or elsewhere, di bahagian leher ke. Okay, maybe ada indigestion, tak boleh hadam. Makan-makan rasa macam indigestion. And also ada difficulty in swallowing. Okay. Okay, itu mungkin antara tanda-tanda awal cancer lah. As you can, as you know, kita ada a lot of type of cancer. Paling famous sekali, breast cancer. Okay, cancer usus. And then you also have blood cancer. You also have eye cancer, nose cancer. Okay, macam-macam cancer. Okay, kenapa? Sebab different parts of your body is made up from cell. So, uncontrolled cell division can cause cancer. Okay, so next part is kita nak tengok more detail into cells. So, there are two types of cell. So, you have animal cell and also plant cell. Come back for part 2. Okay, untuk animal cell dan plant cell.